What is up, vinyl community? Got another round of three records for an episode of 70s Hard and Heavy. Want to start off with this German band, Baumstamm. Really good, excellent album. As soon as I heard this on 70s Hard Rock Fans channel, played a 45, I think, from this, which is insane to begin with. I get a lot of inspiration for my picks from his station. Go check it out. But this was made possible because of a 2009 reissue, so I was able to pick it up for a really good price. The album art is very basic and also misleading with the on tour. None of these tracks sound like, well, there's 9 songs in here. 8 of these songs are definitely studio tracks, with the first one on side 2 having a little bit of live ambient noise in the beginning and end of the song. Not sure if it was a studio track as well with some audio mixed in, but a really good example of 70s hard rock. Really enjoyed this all the way through. It did have 3 softer songs or slower tempo songs, but even then it had really good acoustic guitar layers, almost, you know, reminiscent of like a Led Zeppelin 3, but all of it is fuzzy. So very fuzzed out hard rock and fuzzed out slower tempo songs. And some of my favorite songs on here was track number 4, which is Jazz Break. Side 2 starts off with Girl, I Want to Stay Into Your Fire, which threw me off a little bit. I thought it was a typo, but that is indeed what the singer is singing. I did a needle drop on the first side, whole first side of the record, but then also side 2, track 3, 15 Years Old Mary, which the lyrics are a little bit concerning. So I guess it was written with the perspective of either a 14, 15, or 16-year-old kid. Let's go with that, because it has some of the best guitar solos on this whole album. 2009 reissue on white vinyl. Very nicely done. Sounds excellent. I couldn't complain about the sound at all. What else do I want to comment? Oh, yeah, I got the album. It's a gatefold. And queued it up, sat down on the couch, had a drink, and was getting ready to read about the band while listening to it, and lo and behold, all of the text inside is all in German. So I don't remember enough from taking German in high school to be able to read this, but I get the gist of it. Looks like they started in 75, and looks like they have a new incarnation of the band there in 2008, so it looks like they're still out there rocking, which is really cool. Here, check out this track. In a rush to get that into an episode of 70s Hard and Heavy. It's killer stuff. Forgot to mention that record was actually one of the highest auctioned off records in 2005, an original of that album. All right, next up, I got Orangutan. This was a band that really never was. So there's an insert in here that really covers and sheds some clarity on the band's history and how this album came to be and why there was really never a band to follow. I guess the album artwork, which I think is, it's terrible, but now when you look at it, you identify it with this album, and it becomes one of the iconic hard and heavy albums to find. Luckily, this is a reissue, and I was able to pick it up on the cheap, and it sounds excellent. But the band was originally called Hunter, or The Hunter, and due to poor management and a bad record contract, sound familiar, they dissolved and fell apart. It does have some soft passages in it, some psych moments, hard rock, and maybe even some prog in it as well. Good listen all the way through, but I don't think it's going to satisfy those that are really hungry for the hard and heavy. There's definitely the first track, I Can See Inside Your Head, is killer, and then also Chocolate Piano, track number 4 on the first side, just destroyed me when I heard it. Check out this needle drop here in just a second. Show this record label here on Some More or Summer. Should be able to find a copy of Orangutan for a good price, and you can't go wrong with that track like Chocolate Piano. Next up, final record, Blue Cheer. This is new and improved Blue Cheer. Overall disappointment as far as the heavy gauge goes, but it's hard rock from really the godfathers of heavy metal, Blue Cheer. They've continued to work hard, different lineups of the band through the years. I'm still looking for Outside In or Inside Outside. I'm still looking for that album. So I went ahead and jumped to the third one, but I held out. I held out because these seem to be all over the place as far as prices. But I really held out. I think I paid less than $20 for this, and I'm glad because, like I said, the heavy gauge was on the light side. But really good hard rock. I guess the guitar player on side one quit during the recordings, but then Randy Holden came in, as you know, from Population 2. CD that I showed on an earlier episode of 70s Hard and Heavy. So the second side is definitely my favorite side. Really good hard rock. Definitely digging side two with Randy holding on guitar. And I think I do a needle drop here on Fruit and Icebergs. Great track off of an excellent album, but just not really registering much on the 70s Hard and Heavy scale like these other two. Favorite out of the three, Bomb Stomp. Happy hunting, everybody. Take care.